Fun fact, I loved Empire of Storms by Sarah J. Maas. The Throne of Glass series is my favorite, and that's the first book. Crown of Midnight the second, Air of Fire the third, Queen of Shadows the fourth, and The Assassin's Blade is the novellas. Anyway, Empire of Storms is having its blog tour, and I'm doing a post for it today. And my post is going to be something really special and something to commemorate how much I love the series. I am basically going to be sharing an A to Z of why I love TOG with all of you. Now, for more details on why on each of these alphabet letters, you're going to have to go and check the blog because I wrote it all out. But for now, here's the short version. A is for Aelin Ashriver Galathinius, who is the main character in the Throne of Glass series. She has gone through so much, she has grown so much, and I love her for not being perfect. I know that's a weird thing to say, but I do. B is for battle scenes, and what I love about this series is that there's so many different fight scenes, and they're handled in different ways. And please ignore my drawing skills, I'm not the greatest, but I hope you guys kind of get the gist of what I was trying to do there. Moving on now, letter C, and one of my favorite items on this list is for Kale Westfall, who is my one true pairing for myself when it comes to the Throne of Glass series. I absolutely love this Captain of the Guard, and I just need him all the time, always and forever. He's my favorite. Okay, moving on now. The next letter is D, and that one is for Dorian Haveliard, who is the Crown Prince in this series. And I have had a soft spot for him ever since the very first book, because he's just such a sweetheart, and he's really incredibly kind, even though he's brought up in kind of a strict environment. Anyway, moving on. E is for Elide Lochan, and I hope I'm saying that right, and she is totally a new favorite character. You actually meet her in Queen of Shadows, but it's really in Empire of Storms where she shines. And then F is for friendships, and oh my goodness, squad goals! I swear, I absolutely love the gang that has formed in the series, and they're just amazing. It's gonna be so epic when it ends. G, which is the next letter, is for growth of the characters. I really think Sarah does a great job, especially with Aelin, to let her grow as a character, and with a lot of other characters too. H, on the other hand, is for heart, aka the feels, and I have had a lot of feelings reading the series. I've been angry, I've been sad, I've been happy, I've been swoony, it's just amazing. I is for intricate plotting, and I just love that Sarah has had this whole story in her mind and she manages to incorporate so many details. J is for just so quotable, because there's so many quotes that I love from the series. Rattle the Stars happens to be one of them. K, on the other hand, is for kiss and tell, and obviously I'm talking about the romance. There are quite a few aspects to it in this series, and I just love them all. I have such a soft spot for romance, and I think Sarah does it well. And then L, we have Lysandra, aka who I would be if I were in the Throne of Glass series. I absolutely love her. She's exactly who I'd be, like, honestly. M is for Manon Blackbeak, who happens to be such a badass witch. I love her so, so much, and I think she's like one of the fiercest characters in this story. N is for not just a sidekick, and this actually is mostly for Fleetfoot and Abraxos. Fleetfoot is the puppy that Selena has, Abraxos is Manon's wyvern. And I love them so much. They have their own little moments, and I think that's so special and so great. O, on the other hand, is for On the Writing, and I absolutely love Sarah's writing. I think it's incredibly readable, and I love that it inspired me to pick up a pen and start writing again. I think that's such an incredible thing. And then we have P, which stands for Perspectives, and I love that Sarah has incorporated multiple perspectives into her story, because it gives you such a wide view of what's going on in the world, and I think that's awesome. Q is for queens, and I have to say I really love that there are so many strong females in this series. It's pretty damn fantastic. R is for Rowan Whitethorn, the Fae warrior who, well, we all kind of, he kind of grows on all of us. S is for sass and humor, and oh my god, I love that she incorporates that into her stories. I just laugh out loud a lot. T is for the 13, and those are the gals who Manon leads, and they are incredible fighters and incredibly loyal. U is for unexpected plot twists, and there are a lot of these. I'm not even going to talk about when, which books, but there are a lot. V is for villains, and I actually quite enjoy the villainous characters in the story. I think they're really evil and really creepy. W is for Wolf of the North, Adian Ashriver, who I would choose to be my big brother if I were given a chance, and I love big brothers. He is just such an amazing character as well. I'm going to cheat a little with X and go with Expanding World. I love that ever since the first book in the series, the world has kept growing. Y is for Yes, Magic is Real. I like the magic in this book as well because it really feels like magic, all mysterious and not fully explained. And Z is for Zeal for a Series. I love that I've been able to connect with other fans and it's been incredible. So there you have it, guys. Those were my A to Z of why I love TOG. And if you guys haven't tried the series, you should definitely check it out. And I will see you guys soon. Hope you like this video. Bye!